Welcome to my channel. In this session, we will discuss the basic concepts of polygons and then apply these concepts and solve a couple of questions. And this is the third in the series of these geometry videos that we are making. Now, what is a polygon? A polygon is a closed figure of three or more sides. If it is a three-sided polygon, we call it triangle. Four-sided polygon, we call it quadrilateral. Five-sided polygon, we call it pentagon. Six-sided polygon, we call it hexagon, and so on. And there are two types of polygons. One is a convex polygon, another is a concave polygon. If you look at convex polygon, here this is an example of convex polygon, this is a concave polygon, and I have drawn a line that is intersecting this polygon. Similarly here also, I have drawn a line. And if you observe, a straight line drawn through a convex polygon crosses at most two sides. It will cross maximum two sides. Whereas in a concave polygon, at least one straight line drawn through a concave polygon crosses more than two sides. You can see this. It is crossing one, two, three, four sides, right? And one more important point is, each interior angle is less than 180 degrees. Each interior angle here will be less than 180. Whereas here, at least one interior angle will be more than 180. You can see here, this angle will be greater than 180. Right? So these are two basic properties or basic differences between convex polygon and concave polygon. However, almost all entrance examinations or competitive exams, we get questions only on convex polygon. A few exams like GRE, they will make it very clear that the questions that they'll give will be only on convex polygons. But otherwise also, even other entrance exams, they will give questions only on convex polygons. So here afterwards, in my series of videos that I am making on geometry, anytime that I refer to a polygon, I will be referring to only a convex polygon, right? Now, in a convex polygon, what is sum of the interior angles? Sum of the interior angles of a polygon is n minus 2 into 180, or it is 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees. Suppose if you take a triangle, n here is the number of sides, triangle is three-sided polygon, if n is 3, you can say 3 minus 2, 1 into 180, that is 180 degrees. If you take a quadrilateral, four-sided polygon, 4 minus 2, 2 into 180, it is 360 degrees. Sum of the angles in a quadrilateral is 360, you can say that. So this is the formula for sum of interior angles of a polygon. And sum of exterior angles of a polygon, for any polygon, that is for is 360 degrees, whether it is a three-sided polygon or a four-sided or five-sided, sum of the exterior angles is 360 degrees. And what is the number of diagonals in a polygon? If you take this diagram, see, these are the sides. What is the number of diagonals we can join? The number of diagonals of a polygon is n into n minus 3 by 2. N into n minus 3 by 2. In all these cases, n stands for number of sides of the polygon. Right? This is about a polygon. Then what about regular polygon? What is a regular polygon? Regular polygon means all angles are equal. In fact, all sides also will be equal. In a regular polygon, all angles and sides are equal. Because all angles are equal, each interior angle of a regular polygon will be, since sum of the angles we said is n minus 2 into 180, so each interior angle will be n minus 2 into 180 by n. Or, as I said, 2n minus 4 into 90 is sum of the angles divided by n. So, n minus 2 straight angles or 2n minus 4 right angles by n. This is about each interior angle because all are equal. Similarly, each exterior angle will be 360 by n. Because sum of exterior angles is 360, each one is 360 by n. So, these are some key concepts of polygons. Now, we'll apply and solve a couple of questions. The first one. Find the interior and exterior angle of a regular octagon. Octagon means side of a, n is 8. And what is each interior angle? Each interior angle formula just now we have discussed is n minus 2 into 180 by n. And n is 8. 8 minus 2, 6 into 180 by n, that is 8. You can say 2 threes, 2 fours. 4 45s, 3 45s, 135 degrees. So each interior angle is 135. What is each exterior angle? each exterior angle equals to 360 by n, and n is 8, so 360 by 8, you can say 8 fourths, 8 fives, 45 degrees. But now I tell you one thing, at any point for a polygon, for at any vertex, interior angle plus exterior angle will be 180 degrees. Suppose if you take a triangle here, see this interior angle and exterior angle, it forms a straight line, so sum will be 180. Suppose it's easy to calculate exterior angle because it is 360 by n. Once you know that 360 by 8 is 45, I'm not saying for a triangle, but for octagon or anything, if exterior angle is 45 degrees, interior angle will be 180 minus 45, 135. Easy, no? So that will save time instead of doing this big calculation. Done? So this is about 135 degrees is interior angle, 45 degrees is exterior angle. Let's take up one more. If the number of diagonals of a polygon is 27, find some of the interior angles of the polygon. Number of diagonals formula is n into n minus 3 by 2, that equals to 27. N into n minus 3 equals to 54. Let's not write quadratic equation and find n value. You can now guess from option, guess from factors. N into n minus 3 is 54 means n and n minus 3 means the two numbers differ by 3. Product is 54 means, can you not guess that n is 9? 9 into 6 is 54. Yes, so n is 9, right? So that's how we should guess looking at the factors there. Once n is 9, I want some of the interior angles of the polygon. Sum of the interior angles of a polygon is n minus 2 into 180. N is 9, 9 minus 2, 7 into 180, it will be 1260 degrees. So my answer is 1260, right? So these are a couple of questions based on polygons. Students, for more concepts of geometry, for a detailed comprehensive course, please reach me on my profile at Udemy. The link is given below in the description. You will find a course on geometry there. Thank you.